Our next speaker is Professor Imani Gendi from Zagazig University. Professor Imani Gendi is an active member in the Middle East Fertility Society, has been awarded several awards in oral presentations in different societies. She will present letrozole for preparation of endometrium. Dr. Imani.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for a very elegant introduction. I would like to ask to thank Dr. Hisham Alani for a massive effort and the lovely Ghana family for arranging this beautiful meeting. I'm going to present letrozole and the implantation. Is there a special role? No conflict of interest. I'm not going to tell it as a problem, but learning objectives here is to know some of the implantation marker, because they are very huge. We'll emphasize on some of these. Letrozole and this marker and possible relation with them and modalities for letrozole use. The question, as asked by Dr. Hisham, asked all of us to show in this way, very nice way. Letrozole is an effective ovulation inducing agent. We all know this. But could it possibly underline, improve implantation? Yes, no, or I don't know. Can I know from the audience, Nerfa Edna, if you approve that it possibly improve implantation? Yes, who says yes? So I have difficult task. Who say no? La, it doesn't. Who say I don't know? Okay, thank you. The first objective, well, we know that implantation is the most critical step. Inadequate receptivity, this is from basic science, inadequate receptivity is responsible of 2/3 of implantation failure. Many things are going on for implantation to occur. Many, many markers. First, endometrium proliferate under effect of estrogen. Progesterone cause more and more enhancement of the endometrium. Blastocysts cells enter the uterine cavity and rolls over the endometrium under signals from L-selectin. Chemokines and cytokines, including leukemia inhibition factor, as you can see here, attract the blastocyst to the optimal implantation site. And adhesion molecules, which are 4 members, integrin, cadherin, selectin, and immunoglobulin, firmly attach the blastocyst to enhance further final implantation. From this figure showing the model of embryo endometrium attachment, as you can see here, I will emphasize on integrin and L and the selectin. Here, from the embryo side, selectin starts the integrin starting the process. Then from the embryo side, red circle you see, from the embryo side, integrin. Then from the trophoblast side, integrin. From both sides, integrin. This is a vital role for integrin for this establishment of this attachment. And then here, the selectin also helps in the process, the blue rectangle. So these are rules for integrin and selectin in establishment of embryo attachment and adhesion. Integrin are 3 families, alpha-1 beta-1, alpha-4 beta-1, and alpha-V beta-3. What's interesting about the 3 integrins that they are abundant around the implantation window from day 20 to 24. The 3 integrins are abundant. However, alpha-V beta-3 specifically starts to be expressed with the opening of window of implantation around day 20 and start thereafter. This is for integrin. Therefore, the basis for what they name the soil test, for the soil to receive the plants, it has to be fertile. Therefore, there have been measurement of alpha-V beta-3, which is named as soil test, to see whether the endometrium is favorable for implantation or not. What about leukemia inhibiting factor? It has a vital role in implantation based on hormonal level in infertile patient, abnormal level in infertile, especially in repeated implantation failure. In unexplained infertility, leukemia inhibiting factor secretion weakly increased from proliferative to secretory, and this is even worse in repeated implantation failure. What about both? Whether to count on this only on alpha V beta 3 as they already mentioned in integrity test, or it would be better to combine both. Based on this study in Fertility Sterility 2014, it would be better to count on both leukemia inhibiting factor and alpha V beta 3, because leukemia inhibiting factor shows earlier expression, and sometimes when you see both are absent, it has the worst prognosis. If alpha V beta 3 integrin absent leukemia inhibiting, it's not that bad. If both are present, it is good prognosis. What about the second objective, relation between letrozole and the markers I have already mentioned? This very interesting study by Miller actually is the first to emphasize on a possible role between aromatase inhibitor and integrin. They retrospectively examined women who undergone integrin testing to examine whether suppressing aromatase enzyme improves the outcome in women with suspected defect in receptivity. Timed biopsies obtained using a Babel 8 to 10 days after a positive urinary LH during natural cycle or artificial cycle, where they given letrozole 5 milligrams on day 5 to 9 of stimulation. 15 of their patients had absent expression of alpha V beta 3. However, after receiving letrozole, 10 of the 15 women had expression of alpha V beta 3, and as you can see here, pointer, here, 10 of the 15 after had absent expression, but after receiving letrozole, 10 of the 15 had expressed alpha V beta 3 in a significant value. Well, integrin before, as you can see here in first figure, this was before receiving the letrozole, and after receiving the letrozole, as you can see here, alpha V beta 3 integrin expression increased after receiving letrozole. But very importantly, maybe just because there is cycle-to-cycle variation in alpha V beta 3 integrin, these women had shown the rise of alpha V beta 3. Therefore, Miller and their colleagues, they studied the expression of alpha V beta 3 from, say how it varies from cycle to cycle. Studied the same woman and taken biopsies in follicular and luteal, repeated the biopsies within 6 months, and they observed no cycle-to-cycle variation on alpha V beta 3. And as you can see here, it was almost the same expression within the 6 months. So when we give drug and the alpha V beta 3 integrin was absent, and after that when we take a biopsy and the alpha V beta 3 is present, this is mostly probably due to the aromatase inhibitor. In their group, from 15 women, 50 of the women who had positive expression of alpha beta 3 had higher pregnancy in comparison to 29 who had absent integrin expression. However, 18 of these 29 women who had absent expression, they received the standard Femara or aromatase inhibitor gonadotrophin protocol, antagonist protocol, and they had good pregnancy. As you can see here, the last column showing a pregnancy almost comparable to those having positive alpha V beta 3 integrin. This is another very interesting study by Ganesh, expression of endometrial receptivity markers. They studied alpha V beta 3 integrin, L-selectin, leukemia inhibiting factor, and bonobos during window of implantation in infertile women stimulated with letrozole, clomiphene, and spontaneous cycle. 36 women included, 16 with unexplained infertility, 20 with severe oligoacinoazo. Both groups subdivided into 3 groups, letrozole, clomiphene, or ovulate spontaneously in a natural cycle. Here, letrozole had significant increase in epithelial integrin and in epithelial L-selectin more than clomiphene and control. However, stromal integrin, as you can see here, these markers, stromal integrin, epithelial and stromal leukemia inhibiting factor, stromal L-selectin, these had higher expression. Thank you. Like, as you can see here, this one and this one, the letrozole had higher expression of epithelial integrin and epithelial L-selectin, more than clomiphene and the control. However, these markers were higher in letrozole and clomiphene than control. This was in unexplained infertility. But for male factor, the three groups were quite comparable. This underlying a defect in alpha V beta 3 and selectin in women with unexplained infertility, which might be correctable largely by aromatase inhibitor and to some extent by clomiphene. Here also almost the same figure, as you can see here, aromatase inhibitor having high expression of alpha V beta 3 integrin. What about modalities for letrozole use? The standard is to give letrozole in day 2 and start HMG in day 3 and complete with the antagonist. And this is actually reported in literature, especially with poor responder. A very rising indication is to prepare the endometrium in vitrified warm cycle using aromatase inhibitor. And actually, this study by WHO in women with polycystic ovarian syndrome compared letrozole versus artificial versus HMG. Although women having letrozole had more previous failures of ET, which makes it more challenging. However, clinical pregnancy, ongoing pregnancy, and implantation rate were significantly higher in letrozole than the artificial and HMG group. This large study by Lu, including 1,230 frozen cycles, 713 ovulatory disorder, of whom 359 received letrozole, 354 received HRT, in comparison to 517 normal ovulation. Here, embryo implantation rate and the clinical pregnancy were significantly higher in letrozole and natural cycle than HRT. A portion was significantly higher in HRT than the other two group. Life birth rate was significantly higher in letrozole and natural cycle than HRT. This is another study by our group, retrospective analysis of some of our data in Med Journal. Endometrium thickness was significantly higher in HRT than letrozole. Ongoing pregnancy rate was significantly higher in letrozole than artificial. However, based on this finding, we are running currently a randomized control trial, including 170 patients in each arm, because with randomized control trial, we and the other group all over the world, we will reach to final conclusion. Well, again, I'm underlying possibly, because it is not yet established. Letrozole is an effective ovulation-inducing agent. It could possibly improve implantation. Who say yes? فيش حد مقتنع لسه؟ لا الحمد لله أكتر. No, or I don't know. In conclusion and take home message, ladies and gentlemen, there are preliminary data suggesting beneficial role for letrozole in enhancing many of significant implantation markers. Its value in improving implantation needs to be tested in large randomized controlled trial with different modalities. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Imani Gendi, for your presentation.